And my all-time favorite death scene.
Oh yeah, we always talk about this.
Was in Bud and Lou, right. Where Artie Johnson, as their longtime agent, he shows up at the hospital after Buddy Hackett had another bad heart attack, and he's in the hospital bed weak. And he sneaks in with a strawberry malted. And Buddy Hackett takes a sip of it. Buddy Hackett, as Lou Costello, takes a sip. And he goes, you know, I think I had a lot of strawberry malted in my day. But this one's the best. And he falls over dead.
Oh, my God.
Do you remember that, Bill, with Harvey Korman as Bud Abbott?
Yes, I do.
Yeah.
I also know that there was an Abbott and Costello cartoon.
Oh, sure. Yes.
And I guess there was a guy named Stu Irwin who could impersonate Lou Costello.
Right.
And Bud Abbott played himself. I mean, it was the last attempt to try to make a nickel or two.
Oh,
and then one
God.
Time, he goes in the National Enquirer when it was purely black and white, and it was a real tabloid. They show a picture of him all gnarled up in a wheelchair looking at the camera with, like, his face looked like a post-human face with these little human eyes peeking out from behind it. And they said, you know, if you cared anything about us or our movies, please send me a dollar.
Yes, I remember that.
Pray to God that just never happens to
us. I know. It's like...
If you liked Stimpy or if you liked him to hear him say, oh, joy, you know, send me a buck.
Let's hope it doesn't come
no,
to that.
Send me a Bitcoin. I want a Bitcoin.
And do you remember in the Bud and Lou movie, it's like, you know, both were talented, Buddy Hackett and Harvey Korman, but it looked like neither one of them had ever heard an Abbott and Costello routine.
It did seem like that.
Yeah.
It did seem like that. I mean, you know, to me they were really important. The stuff you used to just take off, you would like jump in an outfit of Lou Costello and just zip it up and fly away with his nuances and everything, and they meeting Dracula, because they really had a movie like that, I guess.
Yeah. So you're saying the Frankenstein monster?
That was so beautiful. Oh.
You say the candle moved. What I remember.
Get it right.
When he's doing that description, and he's describing how Frankenstein's racing out of the crate, and Dracula's coming out of the coffin, and he's moving around. He's miming with his hands all up in the air, at like, you know, like mimicking Frankenstein's moves and Dracula's. And
yeah.
Abbott, just out of nowhere, and you know it's like an ad lib, he goes, okay, put your hands down.